Welcome, I'm Joseph Caulkins, Artistic Director and CEO of Key Chorale, and we hope this presentation will give you some ideas, strategies, and perhaps even a process that you can use to adapt and keep your creative juices flowing, and to keep delivering community engagement and educational outreach even during the most challenging times. While we're hopeful that the worst of the pandemic is behind us, we also realize that any rapid spike in cases or a new variant can change our plans in an instant. Many of our programs were created during the pandemic, and since then we have reimagined and adapted them to in-person and hybrid experiences. We plan to present to you some programs that we've created, and more importantly, to share the process, goals, strategies, decision-making, outcomes, and evaluation that went into these programs. Our hope that is through sharing these programs that it'll spark some creativity on your part, maybe encourage you to start a new endeavor or to adapt a program that you currently deliver. I think we can all agree that we've learned many things and developed new skills during the pandemic. So we encourage you to take those skills and your ingenuity with you as we move into this new phase of the pandemic so that we can continue to find ways to make a difference in our community even during the most challenging times. At Key Chorale, there are general principles that have motivated our decisions both in the early parts of the pandemic and now as we move to more traditional in-person experiences. The general principles that help us in our decision making is to focus on what we can do, not on what we can't. It's all about the possibilities. Keep in mind who it is you're trying to serve and utilize your organizational strengths. Use your creativity and innovation. That's what makes these programs imaginative. And work within a realistic, cost-effective budget. And it's important to memorialize the content or outreach to share within and outside your organization. The greatest outreach or endeavor is not as good if you don't have a way to share that story with others. And also brand your product and always have a donate component with each project. Now we'd like to share with you three programs we've developed for community engagement using these principles. We'll share the overall goals, process, decision making, and outcomes for each. We begin with the first pandemic outreach we did, which we began in March 2020. And in 1 week, we went from the basic idea to the implementation to the completion of the project. And it's called the Come Together Choir Online Choral Rehearsals. So first we set our goals for the Come Together Choir. We wanted to find a way to deliver the program we were doing in person to our two outreach choirs, the Off-Key Chorale for those living with Parkinson's and their caregivers, and the Where Are My Keys Chorale for those living with Alzheimer's and dementia. We wanted to find a meaningful way to connect during the pandemic with these singers. And we also wanted to give them experience that provides a sense of accomplishment and keeps their voices and minds active. And we wanted to create 6 to 8 weekly 60-minute online choral rehearsals, which our public could access and participate in while at home, learning 8 to 10 songs recorded from the perspective of the singer, with each episode building on the previous one. Then we went into the process, the decision-making, the strategies. We first determined what we could do on our own and what expertise we needed from outside our organization. We had the basic idea of what we wanted to do, but we needed additional technical assistance and expertise to make it happen. So we recruited additional people with those skills to help us. We held a brainstorming meeting with our team and our additional community consultants to determine how to produce this outreach and how to deliver this in an easy format for less tech-savvy individuals to access without experiencing frustration. And of course, we had to determine what were the costs of this project. We recorded 2 to 3 episodes at each session with 8 to 10 singers socially distanced. The first 6 episodes we did in 2 days before we all went on lockdown. We also had to determine the process of how to get music to the participants. So our choirs use lyrics or simple music. So we put those into a PDF that we could email to them so they would have the music. We also created a registration process to get music to the participants and to gather information about them. And lastly, we decided to use YouTube and premiere new episodes each week. We used the live chat function to engage with participants during the premiere. Then the episode would remain on our YouTube channel to be accessible again anytime after the premiere. Each episode contained a full warm-up, complete with physical exercises, breathing exercises, and vocal exercises, and each episode worked on basic vocal techniques. Then the rehearsal was just as if we were in person. We had 8 to 10 singers there, and we worked on notes, words, rhythms, musicality, all the things you typically would. And we enjoyed the fun and the therapeutic benefits of singing. Here are a few excerpts just to give you a flavor of the Come Together Choir online choral rehearsals.
All right, very nice. We're going to do a little variation on some of our breathing exercises. The idea is to really work on getting the coordination of these muscles so that we're more efficient when we breathe, so our breath management is excellent. So we're going to do this. We're going to breathe in on four counts, in through the nose on four counts, and then four short puffs of air on a sound, as in Frank. So we'll go in on four, and then four short puffs on a F. Let's try that. So in on four, one, two, three, and four short, one, two, three, four. And I really like the F sound because it takes a lot of air to get, it takes a lot of energy. So you want, again, very active here. Same thing, in on four, one, two, three, four short, and then we're going to add one other piece to it, the third part. So in on four, that's the first part. Second part, we've already done. The last one is one long one over eight counts. And eight counts on a takes a lot of energy and a lot of air. Let's try them all together. In on four. One, two, three, four short. And a long one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. You got the idea. And make sure when you're doing it, remember your posture, that you're really tall. You have elongated sternum. Everything is tall. And when you blow all the air out, don't let yourself cave in, but keep yourself really elongated and open. So here we go. Same thing again. In on four. One, two, three, four short. One, two, three, four long. One, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And this is one you can do at home. Let's try a little variation on that. Let's go a little longer. Four in, four short, and then we're going to go this time to 12 counts. So you have to really manage that. It's a long time on F. Here we go. Ready? And in on four. Two, three, four, four short. Two, three, and a long one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. It's amazing. That's like a long way. So make sure you manage a little bit more. We're going to do the same thing, this time to 12 again. Ready? In on four. One, two, three, four short. And a long one. Let's do a little singing now. This is on ya. Ya, 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 ya. And connect that wonderful sound with your great breathing. Ready? And go.
Ya, 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 ya.
We've done this one before. Me, and really make sure you feel that hinge open up. So you really drop the jaw and let the tongue flatten on the ah. This is me, ah. Ready? And.
Me,
you got it?
Me,
let's review two little spots on this. Look at letter C, just to review that, but it's going really, really well. Let's do letter C, sopranos and tenors, top line, just to review our ba-das. Here's letter C, three, four. Ba, ba da da. And one. Ba da 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 da.
And then all the way up here.
And you did such a great job on that crescendo at the very end. Can you put one here? Ba-da. That would be really, kind of sets off the return of the melody again. Let's do the altos and basses, same thing. We'll give you the lead in. So here's soprano lead in on the G. Bum, two, and alto bass. Ba. And a big breath. Ba. Good. Let's do letter C, everybody. And sopranos and tenors are going to add that crescendo. And we're going to keep going. Here we go. We're going to go all the way to the end. Three, four. Alto bass. Here it comes. And I think we're still trying to learn how this song goes. Not how to sing it, but how to live it, right? So here's the very beginning, gonna lay down. So lots of energy, watch your dynamics for one. Here we go, and. Choirs has a closing song that we end every rehearsal. So here's an example of that. It's Carol Burnett's I'm So Glad We Had This Time Together. Note at the very end, you'll see ways to access more content and also a donate piece. I tell you, great job. That is sounding so good. I feel the friendship with all of you. We want to thank our Key Chorale singers that are with us, our accompanist Jamal Saracoki. Yay! And all of you for joining us. And although we're not with you in person, we're with you in spirit. We feel that connection each week, working with you on these wonderful songs from the Great American Songbook. And if you've enjoyed these episodes, help us spread the word so that others can participate. New singers can register at any time, and all three volumes of the Come Together Choir will be available on our YouTube channel to watch again or anytime you like. And as a reminder, new episodes premiere each Thursday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, now through May 29, 2021. So before we go, let's sing our final song. Here is song number 9, our closing song. Oh, everybody.
It was so successful that we recorded 3 unique volumes, 22 episodes, which now have nearly 7,000 views. This outreach gave us a YouTube presence we didn't have before and allowed us to reach so many more people than expected. What surprised us is that we reached people beside our target audience. People who had participated with us in person, but just couldn't be with us anymore because of health concerns. Singers who just wanted to sing during lockdown. Curriculum for school choirs learning remotely. Members of community choirs who are not currently rehearsing and missed singing. A lot of people we weren't expecting to reach. In fact, nearly 600 people from 577 households signed up for the Come Together Choir. There were participants from 35 states and 5 countries. Singers would rewatch the episodes or just do the warm-up part of the rehearsal to keep their voices in shape. We found that singers could still sign up for any of the volumes, even today they can. And it gave us an opportunity to create 3 themed curriculums with specially formatted music, lesson plans, practice materials, MC notes, etc. We are currently exploring ways to make this available to others to start choirs for Parkinson, Alzheimer's, etc. in their own community. And it got me motivated to finally finish a warm-up book I've imagined for years of more than 200 exercises as a companion to these online rehearsals and the curriculum. And recently, these episodes have been repurposed for Healing Arts Medicine, a platform providing cancer patients with online arts-focused resources to help enhance their treatment and available to patients at over 70 Florida cancer specialist offices. What are some ways that you can take a program like this and adapt it for your course? I think what's great for us is we found it was such a good format. We used it for recording our section leaders and doing online rehearsals for our full chorale. So look at these types of outreach and figure out how it can make a difference in your program. Another program we started during the pandemic was called Morning Coffee and Maestros. With the death of George Floyd, my best friend, associate conductor Jamal Sarakoki, who's also a young black music director, and I were having private conversations about racism, racism in the arts. And we thought we want to have these private conversations public. So we created a new idea, a new format. And the idea was to do something that was not just a pandering message that said Black Lives Matter, but something that really made an impact. And we wanted to get black and white people together having conversations about uncomfortable subjects. And in this case, related to the arts, where we make our livings. Some of the other goals we had was to create an opportunity for Jamal and I to communicate with our public who was locked down in self-isolation and talk not just about racism, but in music in general, explore composers and music that has been underperformed, like black composers or Mexican composers, etc. We also wanted to involve our audience in the conversation. And we wanted to get our audience to use this lockdown time to learn more about music, to explore repertoire and composers they didn't know, and to engage with Key Chorale. When we got to the process and the decision making, we had to first determine what we could do on our own and what kind of expertise we needed from outside our organization. We partnered with a church who had gone to online services and had the equipment to record these episodes. Then we used a combination of YouTube premieres and Facebook Live to include our audience in the conversations and to ask questions of us. Here's the promo for Morning Coffee and a few excerpts from various episodes.
Key Chorale is launching a new interactive event. It's called Morning Coffee and Maestros.
It's your chance to grab a cup of coffee and join in the conversation with myself, Joseph Caulkins,
and me, Jamal Sarakoki. We'll be discussing important topics about music, the arts, culture, and our world.
And you can join in the conversation as well. Each episode will answer your question about the morning's topic. So grab a cup of Joe
and Jamal
and join us and see what happens when you put two maestros in the same room together.
It could be fun.
It could be dangerous.
You're probably right.
What could possibly go wrong? Join us for Morning Coffee
and Maestros.
Hello and welcome to Morning Coffee
and Maestros.
In today's episode, we'll reveal our top 10 miniature masterpieces. While classical composers have often wowed us with large-scale symphonies, masses, and requiems, they have also demonstrated their mastery in a matter of only minutes. So today, we'll be talking about choral works that are 8 minutes or less. Imagine the craftsmanship necessary to compose these pint-sized pieces that pack a punch.
Ooh. And we would like for you to join in the conversation on both Facebook and YouTube. Use the live chat function. Tell us your favorite mini masterpieces or what compositions are most meaningful to you. And please, ask us questions.
Absolutely. And just for you, we've created our top 10 list with recommended YouTube videos of these great miniature masterpieces. So you can click in the link below this video on YouTube or in the comments section on Facebook. You'll be able to download a document with all of the pieces we'll be discussing today, as well as links to these great performances.
And we hope you'll take some time and listen to our top 10 and enjoy those magnificent pieces. While you may know many of these compositions, it's our hope that you'll discover some new masterpieces along the way. We have added a few compositions that we just couldn't squeeze into our top 10. So you can check out our Out of the Cut list with some amazing honorable mentions.
Honorable mentions. That sounds terrible, actually. But I don't know about you, but I thought this was trickier than I thought because there were so many great pieces that I liked. I mean, I love Bach's Singet Dem Herrn and Serenade to Music for Vaughan Williams, mm-hmm. but I go and I go, oh, they're too long. What do I do now?
maybe not so much for me a mentor specifically, but all of these people who from the sidelines almost play a major impact in the rest of your life when it comes to music. So
it's true, and I think when you what I think about it is just the idea of when it's happening in real time, you don't really notice this incredible generosity and all these things, but when you get older and you look back and you go, wow, every one of those points of contact made me a better person, mm-hmm. informed life in a different way. And I bet you this person you're going to talk about, Lucinda Ali, is probably in that category.
Yeah, so before I get into Lucinda, I kind of have to give a few memories getting up to there. So the first picture that you will see up here, I don't know if you can see it yet.
Oh, my God.
That is baby me. So just looking at that picture, you knew I was destined to be a leader of something. I had to be in control.
You look like you're ready to pilot the HMS Pinafore.
I was the captain of something, and I think my mom seeing me look like that and dress like that automatically knew I've got to be a musician of some sort. So the first person that really played the that laid the foundations for me was my grandmother. I think you have a picture of her up there. That was my grandmother who died when I 3 months into my move here to Venice in Sarasota, Florida. And she was a musician all her life, never had the opportunity to become a professional musician. She just wanted one of her kids or one of her grandkids to be a professional musician.
There were several positive outcomes from Morning Coffee and Maestros. First off, we recorded 9 episodes, released every other Friday, which had more than 2,700 views on YouTube and more than double that number from Facebook Live. We increased our YouTube and Facebook presence at a time when we were not performing. And we were able to engage our singers, donors, and our wider audience in conversations and topics we would never have explored pre-pandemic. We also introduced a wider audience to myself and associate conductor Jamal Saracoki. And we brought attention to racism in the arts and underprogrammed, underperformed composers. We shared about the importance of mentors in our lives, talked about the art of conducting, and shared a wider breadth of choral music with our audience. We also included clickable links to composers and their works so that our audience could explore and enjoy performances on YouTube after the episode. While these conversations were free, many viewers donated. And all of these materials are still on our YouTube channel to be viewed at any time. This type of program can be adapted in a variety of ways. Perhaps this could be a format given either live or hybrid, presented before each of your concerts, maybe with your conductor or maybe even interviewing guest artists. Maybe it could be a format that could be like a pre-concert lecture, but one that's pre-recorded in advance and shown before your concert. Or perhaps it could even be a music conversation series you present with another community partner. Another outreach we've developed is Key Chorale At Home Digital Series. Before the pandemic, we didn't video record hardly any of our performances, but after a season of only doing virtual concerts, we've wanted to find the way of creating a viable way of recording some concerts each year for our in-person concerts. We had several goals for our Key Chorale At Home Digital Series. First, we wanted to repurpose video recorded from our virtual and hybrid performances. We also wanted to take 3 recorded videos of performances each season and package them for assisted living and retirement facilities. We also wanted to build a larger audience for our in-person concerts with those in assisted living facilities who can travel to our in-person concerts. When we started working on the process, we first set aside resources to record 3 programs each season and secured the additional funding. We also ensured that the quality of the sound and video were as good as we could afford. Then we created a contact list of facilities with their activities person. Lastly, we needed to build a relationship with the facilities, starting with the largest and most robust facilities first. And what's important is we made a 3-year commitment to this project.
I sing because I'm free. His eye is on me.
This is still a work in progress for us, but one of the outcomes has been that our first series has been seen in a number of facilities, and we're finishing the second year of recorded concerts. And our hope is that in time, this outreach will help us get more facilities to bring more buses for our in-person concerts once they recognize the quality and creativity of what we do.
Educational outreach is an important way the choruses can interact with the local schools and community. Building relationship with school administrators, school choral directors, school staff, parents, and students can create dynamic partnerships and collaborative relationships that can produce effective programs and musical opportunities for students well beyond the classroom. When a pandemic occurs, however, how do you continue to engage with the local schools to serve the students with outstanding musical opportunities? Well, Key Chorale met this challenge through creative ways, and our goal to serve our local schools and community was strengthened. Welcome, I'm Bob Wennberg, the Vice President and Education Committee Chair of Key Chorale, and we hope this presentation gives you ideas, strategies, and ways that you can adapt and continue to creatively develop and sustain dynamic educational outreach during challenging times. Now we would like to share several programs we developed for educational outreach using the principles that our AD shared during part one of our breakout session today. We begin with the first educational outreach during the pandemic, Visible Men Academy. Visible Men Academy is a school of approximately 100 students. It is a K-5 charter school for at-risk boys. Key Chorale and Visible Men Academy began a collaborative relationship 5 years ago, and there was no music teacher or music curriculum at the school. Key Chorale filled that need by providing music instruction and several music programs that enabled students to sing, move, and practice using simple musical instruments. Here is how we stay connected during the pandemic. Our goal in working with Visible Men Academy was to first find a way to meaningfully connect with the students, teachers, and staff during the pandemic. We wanted to demonstrate a caring attitude in a tangible way with the school. And we wanted to create, if at all possible, musical practices and a culminating musical event where students can be actively engaged in singing and moving. Those were our goals. This was the process that we followed along with strategies and decision making. We determined that 4 musical practices outside along with a musical event that would be outside for late May and early June would work. All these activities would be using health safety protocols outdoors. So we determined the cost of the project, staffing needs, our technology needs, etc. And then we developed these. We had music instructors from Key Chorale go ahead and work with the students. Finally, the practices occurred and we had a culminating event in early June. We recorded the culminating event and it was shared with students, parents, school staff, Key Chorale singers, donors, and community stakeholders.
Key Chorale and Visible Men Academy have been in partnership bringing music to these incredible students since 2018. We first got to know each other when we were both involved in a tribute to Dr. Martin Luther King at Temple Emmanuel. Before the meeting, we were kind of gathering around and getting to know each other, and so we asked, "Tell us about your music program." And they said, "We don't have a music program." Well, that resonated with us, and we said, you know, we have the resources, we have the incredible teachers, and we certainly have a passion. And we said, you know, if you don't have a music program, Key Chorale will bring that music program to you. And it's so important that they have access to music, access to the arts. By bringing arts to them, their world becomes not two-dimensional, but three-dimensional. All of a sudden, they can see their part in the world and how music can make a difference. So it's so important with these 100 students that every year they have some touch points of music. So twice a year we come to Visible Men Academy, and I think we learn as much and get as much from the students as we do for them.
We really want to be able to have music that helps as a therapy to our students in their most difficult situations. And from our past experiences, we've been able to do this with the help of Key Chorale.
As a retired music therapist, I have clearly seen how the power of music has inspired a remarkable improvement in the students' communication skills, both verbal and nonverbal, and increased empathy towards others, and generally lifting their moods and spirits while actively participating in these music sessions.
I have a special place in my heart for Key Chorale. They've been with us for several years and been very supportive. Our boys have a lot of energy, and one of the things we use to channel that energy is the arts. It allows our boys to express themselves, but see others express themselves as well.
I can't think of too many things that would be more fun than working with the second and third grade boys from VMA Academy. I wanted to focus on the things I love most about music, which are building relationships and social interaction and working together to produce a final product. It gives everybody a chance to stand in a big circle and face one another and enjoy music together. And to sing about inclusivity, getting on board, coming together, which is a theme we've celebrated all of this year at Key Chorale.
I've taught vocal music for about 35 years, so I really enjoy being a part of this project. I've been teaching with the boys at VMA since we started the collaboration about 4 years ago, and each year it's taken sort of a different form. This year, we really didn't think we would be able to do anything. Trying to teach in a COVID world presented a whole lot of challenges. So when we thought about this in January, we were deep into the COVID pandemic. The school was not having any visitors, but we thought, well, what about teaching outside? The collaboration has really worked. I chose a spiritual gospel, This Little Light of Mine, which I think is perfect for VMA. They have sort of a shine on theme, and I'm hoping that the song will stick in their heads and eventually the whole school can learn it. So it's been a pleasure. I've really enjoyed it this year.
Singing because it makes me feel happy.
A friend is always there when you need it. Yeah.
The outcomes from this Visible Men Academy musical experience in early June was highly successful. We were very pleased and we met our Key Chorale team and the VMA team to reflect on how was this experience for our students. They were all excited that the experience was tremendous. From here, the recording of the culminating event was shared with students, parents, staff, the Key Chorale staff and singers, donors, and community stakeholders. As you think about your community, is there a school or a group of people that could benefit from your expertise? How could you adapt some of our ideas into your programs? What are the tools that might help your organization be successful in providing an educational outreach? 5 years ago, our AD had the vision for a student scholar program. Our board believed in that vision, and our education committee worked with our AD to start developing an implementation plan for this program. This program provides for a number of high school juniors and seniors to complete the application process to see if they can be accepted into the scholar program. It includes completion of an application, interview process, vocal audition. If selected for this program, they get a myriad of benefits, including private voice lessons, participation in a recital soiree later in the spring of each year, along with many other benefits. But when the pandemic occurred, we had to find a way to plan and deliver an effective program for our student scholars. Here are two projects that we designed and delivered effectively to meet the needs of our student scholars. In a few moments, we're going to share with you some excerpts from our recognition event. But first, I want to share a little bit about the process, strategies, and decision-making that took part in developing this program. Our education committee met in February 2021 via Zoom, and we worked with our AD, and we decided for our 7 student scholars this year, we wanted to have a recognition event. Our committee then recommended that we have an in-person end of recognition event using all the health safety protocols that needed to be in place, but we wanted to be in a group setting to celebrate and recognize our scholars and mentors. So we invited our 7 student scholars, their parents, mentors, and designated guests. Safety protocols were in place throughout the recognition event, but the highlight of this program was a beautiful song called Remember My Song. It was sung by the student scholars and mentors. Several speakers also spoke during this recognition event, 2 student scholars and 1 parent, and they reflected on the impact of this program on their lives and their future experiences from this event that would help them. Our artistic director shared about the vision he had for this program and how it's been nurtured and grown over the past 4 years. Students were given a certificate in glass frame, and stipends were given as a form of a scholarship to our graduating seniors. Please watch now this excerpt from the video, The End of Year Student Scholar Recognition Event.
Remember, remember, remember.
As you can see in this excerpt from our recognition event, singers, the mentors, everyone was having a great time. And we decided with this recording to share it with all of our stakeholders. We also reflected on this meeting and saw that the impact of this event was powerful for our scholars. It was an opportunity for all of us to celebrate everything they had experienced during this unusual year. The second student scholar program that I wanted to share with you during the pandemic was referred to as I Dream a Dream Project. This was in January of 2021. So the goal of the I Dream a Dream Project was to provide an opportunity for our student scholars to participate in a special project that they alone could do. Each student scholar sang a portion of the song, I Dreamed a Dream, and then our videographer worked his magic, and he went ahead and did skillful editing to merge these items into a beautiful song. So our process and strategies and decision-making model for the I Dreamed a Dream project was that our artistic director really wanted to involve all of our student scholars in a special and meaningful project during this year of the pandemic. Each student scholar was assigned a portion of the song in December 2020, and our student scholars then studied, practiced their music. And then at the end of January 2021, our artistic director, along with our videographer and others, rehearsed the song. Each of the scholars had the opportunity to reflect on their song and the beneficial experiences that they have had to date in the student scholar program. In other words, they were sharing the impact of the program on their lives and how this student scholar program would benefit them in the future. The final video of the I Dreamed a Dream project was shared with student scholars, parents, mentors, staff, board, and Key Chorale singers. It was then shared with donors and other stakeholders who had interest in this project. Enjoy this video and excerpts from I Dreamed a Dream project.
Unsung, no wine untasted. I can speak through music better than I can speak through words. I'm normally pretty introverted, and music sort of broke me out of my shell.
I also think that music has the power to heal, inspire, and uplift anyone. Depending on whatever emotion you're feeling, I feel like there's some type of music that can connect with anything.
There's always room for improvement, and there's always room to grow and learn. And I thought, with my love of music, what would be a better option than being part of the Key Chorale, and even better, being part of the Student Scholar Program. It's been a dream of mine ever since I heard about it freshman year of high school, and I have loved every moment that I've been a part of this program.
Voices were soft, and the woods inviting. There was a time when love was blind, and the world was a song, and the song was exciting.
So the I Dreamed a Dream project was recorded and live streamed. Each student scholar, as a part of the outcomes of this project, grew musically. This is evident by their own reflections, as well as objective feedback from their voice teachers and artistic director. This recording was shared with students, parents, Key Chorale singers, staff, donors, and various stakeholders. There were more than 420 YouTube views of this recording. This project turned out to be a highlight for our student scholars during the 2020-21 season, and was so appreciated by all of our stakeholder groups. Wonderful projects can be developed during a pandemic, and our donor groups were extremely pleased with the final I Dreamed a Dream product. As we wrap up about the two projects that we shared with you today in the educational outreach section, I wanted to tell you that the impact of the programs that we've shared has been well appreciated by all of our donors and stakeholders. The musical experiences for our students at Visible Men Academy has significantly contributed to their growth, both musically and as people. Our Student Scholar Program has continued to thrive, and the program shared here today has received significant recognition. We look forward to transitioning our programs from the pandemic mode to a much more normal mode. Thank you.
During these pandemic times, Key Chorale, like many other organizations, has actually grown. By focusing on community engagement and educational outreach, our audience has grown beyond the reach of just those coming to in-person rehearsals. We've increased our donor patron base, and our stakeholders are more invested in the mission. And the most important part is our community is better for it. If you want to learn more about some of our programs, we invite you to go visit our YouTube channel or check out our website for more information. We hope these programs inspire you to use your creativity and your ingenuity to reimagine how you deliver community engagement and educational outreach. We have an amazing art form, and we hope these lessons and skills we've learned from the pandemic help us to tell that story even more fully in the future. Remember, what we do is important. Singing is essential.